Friends, welcome to Baba Tech. This is Roshan Sinha, and today we are going to discuss on the mixture grinder. Broadly speaking, mixture grinders are of two kinds. This one is known as a juicer type, and this one is mainly meant for grinding purpose, grinding and blending purpose. Now you can see that there is little difference or variation between the two models. This particular model has got a different kind of gear mechanism that locks with the upper part or the vessel part. So this is a gear kind of a mechanism that locks, and in this case you can see that it has got a very simple mechanism with which it locks the. So now coming to the functionality of these two mixture grinders, this particular mixture grinder has got a mechanism for juicer also, which is like a third box or vessel. The smallest one is usually meant for grinding purpose, for spices and all. The middle one is mainly meant for making juices and all, and the third one is meant for, which is attached here, it is meant for the juicer purpose. Now this particular model has got only two vessels. One is for grinding of spices and the other is for making shakes and all. Now I've opened one of these so that I can demonstrate the functionality. From the top, if we see, then both these mixture grinders have got this particular switch. Now this is like the speed selection switch. So first one is for putting it off, and first one is the, this is the lowest speed, middle speed and the highest speed. Likewise here also you have got 1 dot, 2 dot and 3 dot. For 1 dot refers to the lowest speed, 2 dot higher speed, and 3rd dot is for the highest speed. And if we see the internal part of it, then we can see here that the wire or the lead, this is cracking. So the most common problem with all the mixture grinders or all electrical gadget is the lead becomes old. So you need to replace it after every 3 to 4 years. So this is a preventive mechanism which I advise everyone to use for all their home gadgets, so that you can regularly keep on checking the end points of your lead. If it is developed, if it has got developed this kind of a crack, in that case you need to replace the lead wire. This is the inside of the speed selection switch. Now the different points are connected to the different coil windings of this motor. Now this motor is basically having two carbon brushes, one on this side and the other on this side. So there are two carbon brushes that touches the armature of the coil, and the motor is quite powerful. In both the cases, similar motor is used for all the mixture grinders. In fact, it is very powerful. And once the mixture grinder becomes old, you can use this motor for making drill machine or something of your hobby or interest. Now, there's important part which we tend to ignore or which we don't know about these machines, and that is there's a safety switch attached at the bottom of every mixture grinder. So you can see that the bottom portion has got like one slot here, and here the safety switch is there. I'll show you the bottom of this particular mixture grinder. You can see that there's a safety switch here. If you press it once, it will turn off, and if you press it again, it will turn on. So what happens? This safety switch, as you can see, that it is mentions that it is a circuit breaker switch, and the current limiting capacity for this is 2 ampere. That means if the current exceeds beyond 2 ampere, then this switch is likely to turn off, and you have to reset this switch by pressing it once, and your mixer grinder will once again start. I have seen many families saying that the mixer grinder has become redundant. They are not able to use them. And the only flaw which I find in these mixer grinders is that the safety switch has been put in off state. So you have to simply press it once and your mixer grinder is again ready to work. So this is a protection mechanism that protects the motor of this mixer grinder. Now in this particular case, if you see, this has hardened, so it is not functional. So till I buy a new safety switch, I have made the connection here direct. That means even without the safety switch, I can run this motor. The only thing is that if the current exceeds beyond 2 ampere, and when will that happen? In case of short circuit, it might happen, or that can happen in case if the armature is not rotating, then also the current is likely to increase, thereby damaging the motor. So I'm taking this risk that till the time I'm buying a new safety switch, I have made the connections direct and I'll be able to take functioning from this particular mixer grinder. So I'm sure that knowledge about this circuit breaker will help you in restarting your mixture grinder in case if it stops working in the middle of your process. Thank you for now. Have a great day.